We've delivered a ton of new features to make it easier for users to share and sync their files across web and mobile, at work and at home. For IT, though, my team has been working on three key new features to help you stay in control of corporate data, such as auditing invitation text, limiting which users can share externally, and limiting which external domains your users can share with. We recently showed you how an administrator can limit file sync to only domain-joined PCs. Here are some new controls we've added to manage how files flow outside your organization. In many regulated industries, it's critical to keep a copy of all communications with clients, including any text sent in an external sharing invitation. We've added a new feature to blind carbon copy all of those invitations to a compliance mailbox where they'll be available for later review by an auditor. Let's see how it works. We'll use the SharePoint administration PowerShell to turn on the feature. Now that it's on, we'll configure it with a particular email address we want to use for our compliance archive. With the feature enabled, the end user doesn't notice any difference. They still send their invitation to external users and type in their text just as they always would. But the blind carbon copy is sent to that auditing email box where it's available for later review. In some cases, you may want to discourage your users from sharing externally. In the past, we only had one master on-off switch for all of OneDrive for Business. But we've added a new functionality where we can turn off external sharing for individual users. Let's see how that works. We keep sharing on by default for all users in the organization, as you can see here. But when we need to disable sharing for a particular user, we just set the sharing capability to disabled. Now when the user goes to their OneDrive and tries to share externally, they see a message that explains sharing has been disabled for them. We think external sharing is a great way to help users get their work done, and we'd like to see it turned on for everyone. But perhaps you're worried about people accidentally sharing with a few specific companies, like maybe your direct competitors. My team has been working on a feature to let IT pros limit which external email domains can be invited. To configure this feature, we'll go to the SharePoint Online Administration console and switch to the External Sharing tab. Here you can see we've added a new section, Advanced Settings, which let us control which domains we can share with. In this particular case, we've said you're allowed to share with any domain except the two listed here. If you prefer, you can default to sharing with no domains and add in the specific ones that you want to allow. Once we've added these changes, the user experience makes it very clear what the user is allowed to do. Here I'm able to share with a user in any domain that's not on that disallow list. But as soon as I try to share to one of those blocked domains, I get the appropriate message. Those are just a few of the features for IT professionals my team has been working on over the past few months. We've got many more to come. If you like what you saw today, please go check out the preview, and you can expect to see all of these available in the service by end of year. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.